Hello everyone, this is Professor Shaista Khanum from Vidyavardhini's College of Engineering and Technology. So here I'll be explaining you about how the load and store instruction can be executed using KEEL. So here, first of all, I've created a project, and then in that project I've created a file, and that I've saved that file as .asm file. Then I've included in a group. So this is my program. Here I have first here we are using directives, different directives like area directive, entry directive, then end directive. These are nothing but what are directives, which are called as assembler directive, which are non-executable instructions. Here for these are nothing but directions to assembler, and they are not going to take any memory space. So here what is happening, my first instruction is, this is nothing but what area, which is defining ki what is the type of. So here this is area, and what this is name of the area, that is mass, and these are its attributes. So attributes are code and read only. So here is nothing but one defining this area as a code memory. So an entry is nothing but what, after this it is going to start executing the program. And end is nothing but what, instruction to assembler to stop executing the program. Now my first instruction is, I'm moving some 400000 data, immediate data in R7, and 40004, that is next data in R8. Actually these are nothing but what, my memory locations. Now what I'm doing here, LDR R0 comma into bracket R7. Whenever you write anything in ARM, in 8051 you write at the rate R0. This is similar to writing at the rate R7. So at the rate means what, that register is containing some data, and that data is nothing but an address. So content of that address will be moved in R0. So here the same thing, the only the way of writing is changed. Here we are writing LDR R0 comma into bracket R7, that means R7 ka content is this, and this is nothing but what, see, we moved over here as a data, but actually this is a memory address, and the content of this memory address will be moved into the register R0. Next we are taking the another data in R1, so that is nothing but from R8. And what is R8? In R8 we have 40004 location. So next what I am doing, add R2 comma R0 comma R1. That means I am adding the content of R0 and R1, and I am storing the answer in R2. Next what I am doing, after getting the answer which was in R2, now I am storing the answer into the memory location. Now what is the memory location? Your R7. See, here I am writing store R2 comma R7, R7 comma #8 is nothing but, here R7 is this 04000, and next after 4 byte, next location, normally we can say after 4, it is nothing but what, containing 32 bit data. So next 4004, this is your next data. So after 4 bytes I am storing the answer. So hence I am taking R7 comma #8, that means this will add 8 into R7, so that means 4000008. So on that location storing the content of R2. So this is nothing but what, how the way we are writing, we are accessing a memory, and we are taking the data from the memory and storing the data into the memory. So here the main thing is loading, taking the data and storing the data is through some particular instruction, that is LDR and STR. Now here and addition is done in a register. So the operations are done in a register. So that is nothing but what, a faster operation. So now along with this addition, what I've tried to show over here, see different types of like the way you can write the instruction, and that can change your how the instruction will be executed. See, here I've written R7 is nothing but I'm taking this content and 000, and R8 again I'm writing 400000. So this is nothing but our memory location which I'm moving into R8. So here this is nothing but what, this, when I'm writing like this R8 comma #4, and then I'm writing this colon mark. So this is nothing but a semicolon. This is nothing but what called as pre-indexing with write back. This is called as pre-indexing with write backs. What is the meaning of this? See, here the content of R8 plus 4 will be moved into the R7. And along with it, R8 content will be incremented by 4. See, R8 is nothing but this. So, see, R8 is over here is 0x40004. So, this is nothing but what? We are incrementing the memory location first and then we are taking the reading a data. So, that is nothing but what? Called as pre-indexing. Now, what is write back? What is write back? Write back is nothing but here. The content of this, after doing the addition, this is moved in R8. So, means our two things are already done. You are doing going to the next memory location, taking the data, and the memory location is also updated. So, this is called as pre-indexing with write back. Similarly, we have pre-indexing also and post-indexing also. So, that you can try. So, now we'll go to the execution of this program. So, first of all, we have to build the target. Then, we are going to start debug. Now, over here, I want to first of all enter the data into this memory location because I want to read the data from this memory location and add it. So, first of all, I need to load the data. For that data, here I have written 0x40000. Here it is showing the memory location also. But before that, I need to go to debug and memory map. And in that, over here, I need to define this 0x40000 to 0x400FFF as my read and write memory. So once you do that, then this will allow you to change the data. See, over here, if you don't do this, the thing what I've told you, then what will happen? This will not allow you to store any data. So, here I'm entering the data. So, this is 0, 1, 0, 1, 0. So, this is nothing but what one data I've entered. See, please consider that this location is 1 byte. Second byte, third byte, fourth byte, so total 32 bit of data. Then this is 02 and 02 00. Okay, so this I've taken as data. Now I'll go to the single stepping. So just try to observe what happened. My first this R7 may this data 0x400 has been moved, and my program counter is pointing to the next 4, next plus 4 karke, it is pointing to the next 00004 location. Now next, then I'll execute next. So R8 may this 0x4004 is available now. Now next is nothing but it will load this register. See, this is nothing but R7 is containing 4000. So the content of the location pointed by this 400 location will be moved in R0. So what is in 4000 location? 10201020. So this data should come in R0. So once you execute, you can see this data 10201020 has come in R0. Now next data is 02020000. So that 02020000 has come. Now next is nothing but next is I'll do the addition. So it will add. So, after this addition, this is my answer. Now, I need to store this answer. Where my answer will be stored? 4000 plus 8. So, next fourth location pe this data should be stored. So, just you execute, you can see it is highlighted 12221020. And the special thing, if observe, this is nothing but what? First taking the storing the higher byte and then lower byte. Normally it is lower byte and then higher byte. So that is nothing but what endianness. So here it is nothing but what big endian in which higher byte is stored first and then lower byte, whereas in 8051 we are storing the lower byte first and the higher byte next, that is called as little endians. So you can see now your data is, your addition answer is available over here, 1 2 2 2 1 0 2 0. And the last point, next we need to observe this pre-indexing with write back. So R7, if you execute, R7 is stored with 000. Then next I'm moving R8 mein I'm moving 4000. See, on 400 my data is 1 0 2 0 1 0 2 0. So now what should happen, it will load the content in R7, which is right now 00, with the data pointed by R8, which is 400000 plus 4. So plus 4 kiya, so now it is pointing to 0202000. And so what will happen, so please try to observe what happened. Now my R7 is containing 0202000. So what happened, R8 plus 4 ho gaya, that data has been moved, and your R8 is also updated. That means it is incremented by 4. So this is nothing but what called as pre-indexing with write back. So there is something pre-indexing and post-indexing also with the small changes. So you just go through it and you can try this also. So this is nothing but what I want to explain. So if you have any doubt, you can write to me, and please try this. This is a very simple program and simple to clear your doubts. So thank you so much.